Placing your models really helps bring them to life. Now in the Citadel range there are plenty of kits and materials available to add extra texture and detail to your bases. Now it's always recommended to keep your basing consistent across your force regardless if you've got different colours in your units. It just helps tie them all together. Now in this video we're going to be adding some extra texture to our Grunstock gun hauler. Now you'll notice he's already got some bits added to his base. We've used some Shattered Dominion large base detailing kits on him. We've also added some skulls from the skull pack as well. So what we're going to do in this video is we're going to be using some Astro Granite. We'll be applying that onto the base. We're then going to shade it using Agraxir Shade. We're going to dry brush all over using Terminator Stone. And to finish off, just to add a little bit of extra texture, we're going to be using some of their Midland Tufts. So the first thing we're going to do is start adding that Astro Granite texture. Now the tool we'll be using for this is the texture tool. Now you'll notice there are two sides to it. There's a large spatula side and a slightly smaller side. So what we'll do is we'll spoon it out with that first of all, and then just that's more for fine detail. So the first thing I'll do is I'll use the spatula side like so. Just get a nice scoop of it onto my actual tool. And then what we'll do is we'll start actually applying it to the Grunstock gun hauler. So all I'm going to do is just start spooning it into there like so, just so it's nice and applied. And then I'm going to spin it round and use this smaller side just to add a bit more finer detail. This helps avoid getting over things like the skulls and other textures you might have on there already. After leaving the texture to dry for around about 30 minutes, what we're going to do now is we're going to start applying Agraxir Shade all over that texture and the panels as well. I'll even apply it to the skulls because we don't really need to be super neat at this point. Just apply it all over. And for this, I'm using a medium shade brush. With that shade now applied and dry, we're going to start dry brushing with Terminator Stone. So I'm just going to start on the slabs and the texture just by rubbing it gently like so. And that will really start to pick out those details in the texture. Now, if you do get to any skulls, all I recommend doing is just putting a little bit more pressure on and you really start to see some of that bone actually popping out from the skulls themselves. And by applying a little bit of pressure to the skulls, you'll notice it will really make them stand out. And there we are with that dry brush now done. You can see it's really started to highlight all the texture on there. So what we're going to do now, we're going to finish that base off by applying some grass tufts. And we'll be using our Midland Tufts from the set we showed you at the start. So you can see here, there's quite a few different shapes and sizes that you can use. I'm going to go for something on the middle side. So I'm just going to pick this one here. Now they are adhesive, so you can just pull them off. However, what I am going to do is I'm going to apply a little bit of PVA glue to the bottom of this. Now because they have a sticky underneath, you can actually just apply them straight on. But with a little bit of PVA, it means they'll just stay on a lot longer. I'll just apply a little bit to the bottom like that. And all I'm gonna do is then grab my base. And you wanna look for somewhere where the grass tufts will grow out of. So I'm just gonna go onto this little area just here where there's some sand and grit. Just apply that like so. Now you will see some of that PVA shimmer on the sides, but don't worry about that because when it dries, it will dry clear. So all I'm gonna do now is just go around the model and start adding some more grass tufts to it. And there we are with those grass tufts now applied and dry. You can see they've added some nice texture to that base. Now there are a couple of things to remember when doing any kind of basing. Firstly, we recommend keeping your basing consistent across your force. This will just help tie it together and give it a nice uniformed look. And secondly, if you're using any technical paints, use the texture tool. This will be really handy when applying that to your bases. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video and we'll see you again soon. Bye bye.